very much for joining us in the Absolute Radio camper van.
Thank you for having me. It's a pleasure to be here on this lovely purple sofa.
So you're on the acoustic stage later on.
Yes.
And is this your first time at the Isle of Wight Festival?
This is actually, yes. It's brilliant. I went to Reading last year, but I'm relatively new to festivals, so it's a nice one. It's kind of smallish and it's got a good vibe, so it's good that this is the first one that I'm performing at. We're doing the O2 Wireless as well. So
wow, that'll be a big stage as well.
Yes.
When did you arrive on the island?
We arrived yesterday.
And so did you get to see any of the bands yet last night?
We saw Blondie last night and The Strokes.
What do you think of them?
They're amazing. I love Debbie Harry. She's like the coolest chick ever. Her hair looked so cool. It was like glinting in the sun.
Yeah, she was good, wasn't she?
Yeah.
I mean, she really had the crowd going.
Yeah, she did. They were going absolutely berserk, like literally kind of a mile back. How many people are here?
There's probably about sort of 60, 70,000.
Yeah.
But it always feels like a lot more, I think. Did you wander around the arena? Have you been around to the Strawberry Fields? Or
Actually, no. We haven't. We're staying across the other side of the island, so it's a bit of a drive.
Did you see The Strokes as well then last night?
I did, yeah.
And what did you make of The Strokes?
They were cool. I mean, people were like, he was a little bit monosyllabic in between the songs, but I kind of like that. He's like, oh, have fun camping.
I mean, he was talking a lot about British girls, actually, and how lovely they were. What did you make of that?
Well, I heard that he was backstage a lot, kind of surveying the... My friend Tara was telling me that he was walking around quite a lot, but I didn't see them backstage. Actually, yeah, we did. We saw them in this really low-key van driving off. I thought they'd have like blacked out limo and whatnot, but they were in like a school van.
A little school van. That's brilliant. I love that. That is rock and roll though, isn't it? Surely, you know, The Strokes go off on a little broken down van. That's brilliant. How weird is it to come to an island and do a kind of a gig like this? Do you think it's a bit strange?
It feels strange when you're in cabins here because you kind of still feel like you're on the ferry. I feel a little bit kind of seasick even when I'm on land. I don't know what's going on with that, but it's so nice. I mean, it's perfect weather.
It is beautiful weather, isn't it?
Yeah.
You've got your Isle of Wight t-shirt on, which is really good. What do you think? What have you made of the festival fashion so far wandering around?
Everyone looks really cool. I particularly like the man in the lycra green bodysuit that I saw yesterday. He looked quite cool. He was trying to climb over a fence.
Have you seen any of the naked chefs going around?
Naked?
Yeah, naked chefs with just aprons on.
I haven't seen them. I'm going to look out for them.
A bit disturbing. You're probably lucky that you haven't, I think.
There's lots of sunflowers that I've seen. Is that like the symbol of the
I think
Isle
it
of
is.
Wight?
That's to do, I think, with the honeybees. And they go in selling the sunflowers to kind of make you aware. So, yeah, you should have one.
I know. I haven't actually seen them for sale yet. We haven't ventured out too much into the wild. But I think, well, we got a hot dog yesterday. That was quite an adventure.
Nice. So you're on stage later with your band, obviously, who are here with you as well. How much are you looking forward to performing on the acoustic stage?
It's amazing. Actually, Steve, who's playing guitar, is from the Isle of Wight. So this is a bit of a homecoming gig.
Not anymore.
Oh, that's brilliant. So he's showing you all the sights.
I grew up here, but I'm going to show around the island and all the best places to go.
Excellent. Suzanne Vega's on the acoustic stage as well later on. Did you manage to catch her earlier on?
I didn't. I love Suzanne Vega though. It's so annoying that we're staying so far away and didn't manage to get her in time, but she's one of my favourite. I love her, the tone of her voice, and she's quite a low female singer, you know, in terms of her.
So do you think you might hang around and maybe catch her later on then?
Yeah,
on the acoustic?
I don't know what time she's on, actually. I hope that we do catch her because I love her.
Jay-Z was here on Friday night, obviously. He was on the main stage. He brought Kanye West on as a guest.
Yes.
If there was anybody who's performing this weekend that you could bring on with you and play with you, who do you think it would be?
I would probably go with James Walsh from Star Sailor because I've done some songwriting with him recently, and he's really, really amazing to work with, and I love his voice as well. And because he's got quite a different voice to me, we've sort of sung together as well. I sang at the Hard Rock Cafe with him recently, so I would go with James Walsh.
He would be your onstage partner.
Yes.
That's great. That's brilliant. Finally, one question. Obviously, you've got a famous brother, Robert.
Yes.
Got to ask you, growing up with Robert, was he ever scared of anything? Was he ever kind of, you know, worried about vampires jumping out or anything like that?
Actually, Rob's not really scared of anything. He's such a ballsy person. Sometimes I actually think it might be better that he has some sort of restraint, but he has none. I can learn a lot from him because he's not afraid of anything and he's very confident in himself. He's yeah, he's not afraid of anyone or going with his instincts with things. So he inspires me quite a lot, actually.
That's great. So you'll be thinking about him on stage?
Yeah, I'll be going on with the Rob state of mind.
Excellent. Well, good luck.
Thank you very much.
And thanks very much.
All right, thanks a lot.
Thank you.